Tour, how is the weather in Stockholm?
The weather is pretty good. It's I would say it's pretty much neutral fall weather here in Sweden. It's sometimes warm, sometimes cold.
Are you happy to fight in Sweden, in Stockholm? Is it
Yeah,
exciting?
very much, very much. I like being here in my hometown and not hometown but home turf. So it's perfect.
Is it extra pressure for you or extra support?
I would say both. I mean, I kind of like the pressure of it. Of course, it's extra pressure when I'm in my hometown, but I also get extra support. So it's kind of both.
Are you happy with your preparations?
Yeah, I'm happy.
Okay. No problems, no injuries on the way?
No, I pretty much went the way I wanted it, and I've been a lot of down in Stockholm training there, and yeah, pretty much as I wanted to have in my preparations.
You are going to fight Polish Krzysztof Jotko. What do you think about your opponent? Did you study him well?
Yeah, of course. We watch a lot of his fights, and a lot of my coaches watch a lot of his fights too. So we have a good game plan for him. But he's a tough opponent. You know, he's very athletic, and he's good on his stand up. So it's gonna be a good fight.
Magnus Sedenblad used to fight with him and won, of course. Did you got some extra tips from Magnus how to win with him?
Yeah, we train a lot together for this fight, so definitely we exchange some words about Jotko, of course, but I mean, it's a fight. You never know what to expect in a fight. It's just go in there and do what you believe to do.
Do you think the stand up is his strong the mo the biggest strength of Jotko?
Yeah, I think so.
Your two last fights didn't go well for you. You lost by decision two last fights. Do you feel like you must win this one to stay in UFC? Is it extra pressure for you because of this?
I definitely feel that I need to win this fight. I don't feel like it's extra pressure because, I mean, pretty much every fight is like this in our sport. And I feel like even if you're outside of the UFC, you have to win to get into the UFC. So I wouldn't say it's a different pressure, but I know I need to win this fight.
Your opponent has separated with his coach recently. Are you aware of this situation?
No.
Okay, he did
No.
like two weeks ago. They
Okay.
had some misunderstandings and they separated. Do you think it will influence him in the bad way?
I mean, I don't know. I can't speculate on that. He's probably so tough he can do that without anyone in his corner at all. I mean, it doesn't really matter who's gonna be there. He's gonna do his work anyway. So I don't think it's gonna do any impact on him. No.
I see. I would like to come back to year 2007. You thought Mamet Kalidov, the Polish guy with Chechen roots,
Yes.
this was your first loss, right? Do you remember this fight?
Yeah, I remember that fight. It was I mean, I took the fight on pretty short notice, and I know Mamet was a tough fight, but I saw it as a challenge for me to have that fight, and especially go to Poland. I like to be there. I've been there a few times after that too, both fighting and training. So I like Poland. You know, I like to go there, and I like the people there.
Nice to hear. I'm asking about Mamed because he's currently the best Polish fighter we have. It's always a problem for KSW organization to find a proper opponent for him. And I was just wondering if you keep track of his advancements, maybe.
Yeah, of course. I mean, I always watch his fight. I think he's an entertaining fighter and a very good fighter. He always performs. I mean, he's a very athletic, and he always performs in his fight. So I think he's one of the best fighters in the world, I would say, in our weight class.
Would you like to fight with him again someday?
I mean, of course, I fight pretty much anybody, anytime. So for me, it's not about like dodging fights. I take any fight I'm given. So I mean, of course, I like to fight him again.
You are skilled not only in MMA, you have master's degree in engineering physics. I heard that you've been doing some research in mathematics as well. Do you think about your like career after MMA professional career? Will it be connected with mathematics and science?
I haven't really decided right now. Right now, I'm very happy with having both in my life. I both have fighting and my academic side too. So I'm happy with having both. But I don't know what I'm gonna do in the future. Maybe I continue the academic part, or maybe I still be in the martial arts after I'm finished with that. Maybe I who knows? You know, I can do something else too. It's for me. It's all about finding what I like to do and what I want to do. So it's not about like, well, my education or really what I'm good at. It's more like finding stuff that I like to do and I can find joy in life with.
It's nice to have options, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. And that's the way I see it with my education and what I do right now. It gives me a lot of joy in my life, and I'm happy to have options to do what I want to do after this.
Great. I was wondering, is MMA a big sport in Sweden?
Yeah, it's actually becoming a very big sport since UFC came here, and we had three shows soon. So it's gonna be, I think it's gonna grow even bigger in the couple of years. So I think it's gonna continue to grow, but it's a very big sport here right now.
Okay, Tor, thank you very much for the interview and good luck on Saturday.
Thank you very much.